Geek-a-saurus.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you come in.
That's funny.
Alright, hey there. We're going to do a character creation session with the D&D Basic Rules. We have the starter set. We have Nick the Vegan. I'm Hal from RPG MP3. And I guess this is us starting Geek-a-saurus again. So, we're going to go through the character creation, as is written in the basic rules, which means we're going to be rolling for stats rather than using the standard basic set.
My problem with the basic set is that almost everyone in there is, like, lawful good.
Oh, the basic set of characters from the starter set.
Yeah.
They are all lawful good, or neutral good, or lawful neutral, which is the flat worst alignment to be. So, we're going to roll stats. So, roll 6 times 4d6... keeping the highest 3 and write them down the side. It's going to sound a little like 13. 13! Write it on the side somewhere. Roll it on there. It'll be a lot quieter.
Okay.
Roll them.
I roll them again?
Yep, roll them 6 times.
Oh, 6 times.
6 times. That's good. That's a big... That's a 17. That's good. That's good.
All right, let's get more of those in.
Yeah, less 6s. 3s. There we go. That's a 12.
That's not terrible.
It's not terrible. 12 is better than... Average is 10 to 11. That is an 11. We're getting slowly smaller. Wow. 2 more. Let's see if we can keep them all in double figures. Oh, that's still good. That's a 15. You have good stats.
How many times did I need to do
one
that?
More.
One more.
One more. This is your dump stat. Congratulations to an 8.
Which still, as a dump stat.
To be honest, you're above the average because the suggested spread is 15, 14, 13, 12, 10, 8. So you've actually got better than that.
Yeah. My lowest one is their lowest one, right?
Yes.
But I've seen stats where people roll like once.
Well, generally what I allow is if you have a terrible stat spread, I'll let you roll the whole spread again.
Yeah.
Your stat spread's fine, so we'll carry on. Technically, that was step 3, but because we've played D&D many times, we're going to generate stats, because that's what we do.
What was step 1 and 2?
Choose a race and choose a class. Okay. So what race do you want to be? Because of the basic set, you can be an elf, a dwarf, a human, or a halfling.
I have decided to be an elf, and I believe more specifically, a wood elf.
Wooden elf.
Yes.
So you want to be a wooden elf. So write down that in your race, wooden elf.
I believe it's just wood elf and not...
It is wood elf.
And not wooden.
Well, we'll see how you roleplay it, won't we?
Oh, bossy.
Okay, so as a wooden elf, you get... Oh, let's spread your stats first. So do your stats spread. Let's do figure out what class you are. What do you want to be?
I believe I was going to go rogue.
Going to be rogue?
Yeah.
Type in rogue into class, and your level is...
For now.
Okay, so spread your stats first. So, as a rogue, it recommends that your stats should be, I believe, dexterity and intelligence.
As the highest?
That's what you get bonuses for when you save. Right. So, it thinks... So, yes. You're getting bonuses on dex and int. Whether you want a high int or not, it depends on the skills you're likely to pick. So, I would suggest that dex should definitely be your highest.
Yeah, my 17's going to go in dex.
Okay. Constitution is important for everybody because that determines hit points.
I'm thinking...
But then wisdom is for things like spotting stuff, charisma is for things like persuading people, and strength is for lifting things. But with the new system, if you choose finesse weapons, your dexterity can do your 2-hit as well as your damage. So if you're using like a short sword, you roll with your dex bonus, and it also results in your damage as well, adds to your damage.
So I can have a lower strength then?
Yes,
for those.
Which is great for people now. Now you can play a proper dex fighter without having to dump... Well, if you dump stat strength, you were just doing no damage but hitting all the time.
Well, I was probably planning on doing a lot of archery.
So, okay, go
so
on.
So I think for strength, I'm going to do...
The 8. Oh, I like that. You have negatives for strength. That's good. That's not bad. That's fine.
I mean...
As long as you're not lifting nothing... Don't carry any heavy armor.
Aside from,
all that treasure.
Well, what archers do you know wearing full plate mail?
Not many.
Exactly.
I was talking about this system before. Apparently it seems that wizards no longer have the restriction on not wearing armor.
Really?
Yeah, apparently as long as you're proficient with the armor, it doesn't restrict you anymore. So if you start as a dwarf, you're automatically proficient in light and medium armor, which means that you could start as a wizard with medium armor, which is kind of nice.
Maybe not be the first to die!
Exactly, well, it's still probably. But to be honest, mage armor, I don't think you start with enough money to get decent armor, and I think if you go with dwarf and mage, there's no way to start with armor from your starting equipment in the basic set, so you would be a wizard starting with no armor who probably didn't pick the mage armor spell. So your armor class would be terrible until you get to somewhere you could buy armor.
Really? Ideally, I would be playing this character as probably like a wood elf ranger.
Okay.
But since ranger isn't there, I figure rogue is the...
Yeah, either that or fighter, but I think wood elf is the way to go regardless. So, spread your stats.
Okay.
That's to be spread. Constitution, you need a good one.
Constitution, so you think the 15 or the 13 on that one?
It's due. Makes a difference. Put the 15 in there. And then you've got, what, a 13, a 12, and an 11.
Yeah.
So you can either be smart, wise, or cheery.
I like charisma. I like playing high charisma, because then I get to, you know, hit on women and convince people to do my bidding.
I like that. Hit on women.
And then I'll do, I guess, intelligence at 12 and wisdom at 11.
Sounds grand. Okay, so as an elf, you get an immediate +2 to your dexterity, so that puts that to a 19.
I'll just go ahead and...
And as a wooden elf, your wisdom goes up by 1, so that puts that to 12.
Could have told me that sooner.
Sorry.
Before I wrote things.
Sorry. All part of the fun. So now you have your ability modifiers, which is the bonuses. Technically, if you look at the main sheet, the bonuses go in the big box and your actual stats go in the little box, but that didn't make any sense to me. So I've done it the other way around. So an 8 gives you a -1. The 19 gives you a +4. 15 gives you a +2. Your int at 12 is a +1. Wiz at 12 is +1. 13 again is +1. That's not bad. That's real good. That's real, real good. So, also as an elf, you get... It tells me about alignment. Size, your medium. So your size is... Somewhere around... Oh, I just wrote it into the... I want to say...
Features and traits?
Yeah, scribble it in there. Medium size. I don't think it really matters. Your speed is 30 feet. It goes in the speed box.
I think as a wood elf...
Oh, yes, you're right. Your base walking speed is 35 feet. I was just going to be elf first.
That's fair.
You get dark vision at 60 feet.
All right. So would that go under my features?
Features. Features and traits. Dark vision at 60 feet. You have keen senses, which makes you proficient in perception. So you can just put a scribbly dot next to perception.
A scribbly dot?
Fill in that dot. Bubble in that dot. So it's like being back at school. You have fey ancestry, so you have an advantage on saving throws against charm. So in this box, write advantage versus charm. And magic can never put you to sleep.
No sleep from magic.
No sleep from magic. You also trance instead of sleep, which means that instead of sleeping, you meditate for 4 hours. And that's as if you had slept for 8 hours. That's a good thing. Mm-hmm. Languages you start with are common and elvish, which I just scribbled in that box there. There we go. And now, did you pick the wooden elf?
Yes.
So you are proficient, which goes down here as well in proficiencies. You're proficient with longsword, short bow, and longbow.
Alright, so long and short sword.
Yep, and longbow and short bow. You also have something called Mask of the Wild, which you can attempt to hide even when you're only lightly obscured by foliage, heavy rain, falling snow, mist, or other natural phenomena. That's going to go over here.
What was it again?
Mask of the Wild.
Mask of Wild, and that gives me better hiding.
It means that you can attempt to hide when you're only lightly obscured. So you can basically dive in a bush and attempt to hide. Normally you can only hide when there's something, you basically walk out of sight.
Yeah.
But this is only lightly obscured, so if it's raining heavily, you can kind of back away into the rain and attempt to hide. Which is kind of weird, but also kind of good. Okay, so that's everything from Elf.
Alright.
So let's jump to Fighter and see what you get from that. No, you're not a fighter, you're a rogue.
Yeah.
Key. Alright, class features. Hit dice, 1d8. That goes in there. But total is 1d8. 1d8. Because hit dice now, when you do a short rest, you can spend your hit dice and roll them in order to get back hit points when you do a 1 hour rest.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and if you do a full rest, everybody gets back all their hit points.
Okay.
So that's kind of nice, so you don't have to have the cleric pumping people full of fuels all the time.
So a full rest, now, is that a full rest, like, for sleep?
Yeah, or? It's like an eight, there's two types of rest, the short rest and long rest. Short rest is at least an hour, and during that time you can spend hit dice, and you roll them and get back that many hit points. And during a long rest, basically it's an 8 hour rest that can't be interrupted by longer than 1 hour of strenuous activity. And during that time, you gain back all of your hit points and everybody regens their spell abilities like it used to be.
Or 4 hours for me.
Or 4 hours for you.
Well, I'm in my sweet, sweet trance.
Exactly, in your sweet, sweet trance. Your starting hit points at level 1, which go here, are 8 plus your con mod. So that's going to be 10, which isn't bad. 10.
10.
8 plus 2. Very good. Okay, so you have additional proficiencies from being a rogue. You go down in the proficiencies box. You're proficient in light armor. You're proficient with simple weapons. Hand crossbows. Long swords, which you've already got, I think. Rapiers and short swords, which you've already got, I think. You're also proficient with thieves' tools. Your saving throws with which you are proficient, bubble these in, are dexterity and intelligence. I like now how you're proficient or not, which is kind of nice. See, everybody can try everything, and proficiency just adds. So your proficiency, which is here, proficiency bonus as a level 1 character is plus 2, and that's the same for everybody. So if you do something with which you're proficient, you add plus 2 to it, and every time you do something you're not proficient in, you don't add plus 2 to it.
That's
quite simple. Okay, so you have skills. You can choose 4 skills to be proficient in from the following list. Acrobatics, athletics, deception, insight, intimidation, investigation, perception, performance, persuasion, sleight of hand, and stealth.
All right.
Are you going stealth?
I think I'll do stealth.
Let's go stealth. Stealth is good. Acrobatics?
Acrobatics.
Yeah.
I think would definitely be good.
Athletics, deception, insight, intimidation, investigation, perception, performance, persuasion, sleight of hand, and stealth. You have 2 more.
I'm aware.
I know, I'm just helping.
I'm thinking.
Fill in that blank air, you know?
Yeah.
That blank air where the grinding of your brain can be heard.
I'm thinking maybe...
Choices.
I know, it's difficult.
I know.
I think all
this for a plus 2 bonus.
I know. The 3 I'm kind of looking at are survival...
You don't have that as an option?
What?
You don't have that as an option?
I don't?
Nope.
I'm sorry, it was on the sheet.
So I know. Don't have that as an option.
Alright, go through and I'm going to cross out things that I...
Just acrobatics, athletics, deception, insight, intimidation, investigation, perception, performance, persuasion, sleight of hand and stealth. You said you wanted to be a bard. You can have performance.
I don't want to be... No one wants to be a bard.
You could be a bit of performance. It's good.
I mean, my strength is already pretty low, so I'm not sure if I want to add a proficiency in it.
It's not going to benefit you that much, but, well, if you have to roll it, then it's going to be the difference. Plus 2 might be the difference between pass and fail.
For athletics, yeah.
Athletics is more kind of the...
Well, athletics is strength-based.
Yes, so. Whereas acrobatics is not... They're similar in skills, but they're not quite the same.
Can you go ahead and...
Find out what they mean.
Yeah.
Yes, let's give you the rundown on the skills. Where are they?
I mean, stealth and perception and...
Actually, I think they're back here inside of the class of the actual ability scores descriptions. I'm not 100% sold on how this book's laid out, but we're getting there. Athletics is your strength check covers difficult situations you encounter while swimming, climbing, jumping. Examples include your attempt to climb a sheer or slippery cliff, avoid hazards, you try to jump an unusually long distance or pull off a stunt mid-jump, or you struggle to swim or stay afloat in treacherous currents. Acrobatics is Your dex acrobatics check covers your attempt to stay on your feet in tricky situations, such as when you're trying to run on sheet ice, balance on a tightrope, or stay upright on a rocking ship deck. Both might be appropriate. Yeah. You're planning on being the outdoorsy type.
Yeah, let's do athletics.
Yep.
You know my strength is pretty low.
Give your plus.
Yeah. The thing is between intimidation and persuasion.
So they're both charisma skills, correct?
Yeah. I gotta do something with my...
Okay, intimidation is your attempt to influence someone through threats, hostile actions, and physical violence. I might ask you to make a charisma intimidation check. Examples include trying to pry information out of a prisoner, convincing street thugs to back down from a confrontation, or using the edge of a broken bottle to convince a sneering vizier to reconsider a decision. Persuasion is when you attempt to influence someone or a group of people with tact, social graces, or good nature. The choice is yours. This is the character forming decision. Do you take intimidation?
That is. Like...
Do you take persuasion? That's it. This is. There was a fork in the road. There's deception, which is you can convincingly hide the truth either verbally or through your actions.
Oh, there's
performance. God. You can delight an audience with music, dance, and acting.
That is. This is seriously the story. This is not just like the story of my character. This is the story of my life. Do I want intimidation or persuasion?
Alright, there's bards, paladins, sorcerers, and warlocks use charisma as their casting step. Warlocks. Warlocks.
Warlocks.
Chill on. Scribble in that dot.
I'm gonna go with intimidation.
I figured you would. Yeah,
I think it was a broken bottle that swayed me.
That's right, you vizier. Fuck you, dude. Alright, so. That's your skills chosen. Now you have your abilities as a level 1 rogue, which I think are going to go over here somewhere. You get expertise at level 1, and expertise lets you choose. Here we go again. 2 of your skill proficiencies, or 1 of your skill proficiencies and your proficiency with thieves' tools. Your proficiency bonus is doubled for any ability check you make that uses your chosen proficiencies. So basically, you have a proficiency of +2 right now.
Yeah.
With these 2 skills or 1 skill in thieves' tools, you would get +4 when you roll them.
So I choose 2 of these?
Yeah.
To...
Yeah, you're an expert in these 2 specific skills.
Oh.
More expert than most people. Or you can have 1 skill and thieves' tools.
Oh.
So when you're picking locks, you're extra proficient. The rogue I rolled up had stealth and thieves' tools.
I think I will go with acrobatics and athletics. So
should
I
put a mark next to it? I'll write it down here in expertise and write it down there, and then put some kind of mark on there. We'll actually do the totals here. So when you write the total in, just make sure you double up the bonus.
All right.
So what are you going with?
Acrobatics and athletics, since he is a ranger.
Oh, the outdoorsy type.
Yeah.
Okay, you also get sneak attack, 1d6. The sneak attack must use a finesse or a ranged weapon. Once per turn, you can deal an extra 1d6 damage to one creature you hit with an attack if you have advantage on the attack roll. You don't need advantage on the attack roll if another enemy of the target is within 5 feet of it. That enemy isn't capacitated. So basically, if your fighter's fighting someone, you don't need to have advantage. You're basically considered to be flanking them. Or they're distracted, so you can shoot
them.
So
I'm almost, if someone's fighting them, I'm almost constantly like just flanking if I'm from a distance.
Yeah, this is a strange thing. It says you don't need advantage on the attack roll if another enemy of the target is within 5 feet of it. That enemy isn't incapacitated. But it says you can do it with a ranged weapon. So I'm guessing if they're fighting someone, you can still shoot them and get sneak attack.
Sweet.
Yeah, that's what I'm reading that. Unless it clarifies it in Player's Handbook, that's how it reads.
So I would throw a 1d8 and a 1d6
mm-hmm.
for that?
Oh, yeah. Right. Okay, you also get Thieves Cant, which is a magic thieves language, which is like gutter tongue and weird signs, and lets you leave like thief signs on doors.
That'll be good for my intimidation.
Yeah, you can talk garbage to someone.
I'll talk garbage and...
It means you can talk to the other rogue in the party in thieves' cant.
And they won't be able to understand what we're saying.
Exactly.
As we plan to rob them in their sleep.
That's right. So, equipment.
Right.
So, you start with either a rapier or a short sword.
Can I get the differences in their...
Yes, you can. A rapier is long and pointy, and a short sword is fat and pointy. You mean looking at the stats?
Yeah.
I believe a short sword is considered a finesse light weapon, whereas a rapier is considered a finesse weapon. Let's see. Rapier is 1d8 piercing, weighs 2 pounds, and is a finesse weapon, which means you can use your dex to hit and damage. And the short sword is a 1d6 piercing, it weighs 2 pounds, and is finesse and light. If you're considering two-hand wielding, I would go with the short sword. If not, I would go with the rapier and a bow for the next item.
Yeah, I'd go with short sword.
I'd go with them. Are you planning on using two short swords?
No.
I'd go with the rapier.
Oh, the
rapier does more damage.
Oh, I thought you said it was if I was...
No, oh, yeah, if you're wielding two short swords.
Okay, short so sword if I'm hand. Doing a bow...
Go with a rapier.
All right, just write it in right
there. Just write rapier there and we'll fill in the stats in a bit. So your second option is a short bow and quiver of 20 arrows or a short sword.
Short bow.
Good. And 20 arrows. Your next one, contentious choice, is a burglar's pack, a dungeoneer's pack, or an explorer's pack.
Okay, I was reading over these earlier, and I want to point out...
That clearly the burglar's pack is better.
Clearly the burglar's pack is better. I think it's a kind of flaw in the way they set it up. It costs more, and is... like, clearly better.
It has good things in the Dungeoneer's pack.
But, I mean...
Oh, there's a lot of it's already in the Burglar's pack.
Yeah, a lot
there's, of... Yeah, there's not a lot that isn't... Yeah, there's nothing, I don't think.
The only thing I've got better is a bedroll.
Dungeoneer's pack doesn't even have that.
No, the Explorer's pack.
The Explorer's pack gives you a bedroll. And a mess kit. And then you get a tinderbox. Yeah, I'd go with the Burglar's pack. It's just... clearly better.
I mean, it's... And I don't even want to play, like, a burglar character, but they've left me little to no choice.
You get more... With the Explorer's Pack, you get more rations, and you get the same amount of torches.
Same amount of torches.
No, you don't get a torch with the Burglar's Pack. You get candles, and you get a lantern.
Which is almost the same thing.
Yeah. You get a mess kit, Yeah, I'd go with the Burglar's Pack. With that, you get a backpack, a bag of 1,000... Just read Burglar's Pack. Bag of 1,000 ball bearings, which is interesting. 10 foot of string, a bell, 5 candles, a crowbar, a hammer, 10 pittons, a hooded lantern, 2 flasks of oil, 5 days of rations, a tinderbox, and a water skin. And you also have 50 foot of hemp rope.
The only thing that I would want from the Explorer's Pack is like the bedroll.
Which you can buy one of, because you're going to start with some money. So the first town you get to, you buy a bedroll, which costs you 1 gold piece.
And maybe some extra rations, which are like 1 gold piece apiece.
Rations. 5 silver. I always thought rations were heavy. They're 2 pounds for one.
The fuck? Oh, I know an MRE does not weigh that much.
Well, this is like dried meat and like...
That's what an MRE is! They don't weigh that much.
Apples. I don't know. Trail rations. Let's see what it describes trail rations as, shall we? Water. What was that, the third wall?
Water that weighs.
Now, water goes in your water skin.
Or wine. I assume they mean wine skin.
Wine skin.
Because I'm
exactly.
Filling that with booze.
Rations consist of dry foods suitable for extended travel, including jerky, dried fruit, hardtack, and nuts. 2 pounds of jerky, dried fruit, hardtack, and nuts.
It's a hardtack that weighs so goddamn much.
Just check that out and just go with the fruit and the nuts. Okay.
Oh my god, what if I made my character a vegan?
Don't do it. You're just eating dried fruit. Nobody wants to travel with you.
I've been pooped for 10 days. I ate so much goddamn dried fruit.
Okay, additional equipment. You get leather armor.
I'm sorry, I refuse to wear
leather armor. Okay, right. I refuse to wear leather armor. You're naked. 2 daggers and some thieves' tools. I like that spy. I'm vegan. Oh, no, you're not. Not in my game. Not in my game, you
are. What would happen if someone's character decided to go vegan?
It could be. I mean, it could be just cause huge problems when you're in the wild starving to death and all you can get is animals.
Nuts and berries.
And you're in the desert.
Cactus. I'll eat the shit out of some Nepalis. You've seen me do it.
I've seen you eat the shit out of some cactus.
For people not from Texas or Mexico, Nopales is a type of cactus that you cut up and it's really good if you like grill it and put it in a burrito.
I've never had it.
Oh, it's so goddamn good.
Maybe one day. Okay, now you get to choose your background.
Oh, shit. is.
So this is kind of where you've come from. Now, the other rogue chose criminal, because it made sense. You have the option of being an acolyte, which means you've spent life in the service of a temple.
No.
Well, there's options. It gives you proficiencies in insight and religion, it gives you two languages, and gives you a bunch of equipment. You can be a criminal, which gives you deception and stealth, it gives you proficiencies in a gaming set and thieves' tools. It's a way for someone who isn't a thief to get thieves' tool proficiency, which I think is kind of cool. Mm-hmm. So you could have a wizard with thieves' tool proficiency.
Except they don't actually do it with their hands, they just...
That's right, also. And thieves' tools are floating in the log.
That's right.
It gives you a bunch of equipment. You can be a folk hero. Ha ha! I know, it's funny, right? Which gives you a bunch of stuff. You can be a sage, which is like you've spent the time learning the laws of the multiverse. So you're like the wizardy one. Or you can be a soldier.
Those are my options.
Those are your options for backgrounds, yes.
Let me hear that folk hero one.
Folk hero! You come from humble social rank, but you are destined for so much more. Already the people of your home village regard you as their champion, and your destiny calls you to stand against the tyrants and monsters that threaten the common folk everywhere. You can put some reverb on there. Everywhere. You're going to Michael Bay that shit.
I like that you assume when I said, let me hear about the folk hero, you thought I meant, let me hear the description, when what I really meant was, what the fuck do I get from it?
You get animal handling and survival as skill proficiencies. You did want survival.
Mm-hmm.
You get one type of artisan's tools and land vehicle proficiency. You can drive carts and shit.
I'm going to get a fucking motorcycle.
You get equipment. You get a set of artisan's tools of your choice. A shovel, an iron pot, a set of common clothes, and a belt pouch containing 10 gold. You also get to pick a defining event that led to your status as folk hero. And you also get the feature rustic hospitality, which means since you come from the ranks of the common folk, you fit in among them with ease. You can find a place to hide, rest, or recuperate among other commoners unless you've shown yourself to be a danger to them. They will shield you from the law or anyone else searching for you, though they will not risk their lives for you.
Let me ask you this.
Yes.
If I choose folk hero, will Bob Dylan write a song about me?
Absolutely. Dude, you could
folk hero!
Dude, you're Robin Hood. It's Robin Hood.
So background is folk hero?
Correct. You're Robin Hood.
Alright, so I get
animal handling.
And survival.
Yes. And if I see you handling those animals inappropriately.
Hold on, I'm not Welsh, okay? Not Welsh.
Well, you get proficiencies with vehicles, land. And you also get one type of artisan's tools with which you are proficient.
Right.
And they are alchemist supplies, brewer's supplies, calligrapher's supplies, carpenter's tools, cartographer's tools, cobbler's tools, cook's utensils, glassblower's tools, jeweler's tools, leatherworker's tools, mason's tools, painter's supplies, potter's tools, smith's tools, tinker's tools, weaver's tools, woodcarver's tools.
Which of those would allow me to make more arrows?
Maybe woodcarvers? Maybe, but I don't think so. None of them are boyer's tools. Artisan's tools. Proficiency. The set of artisan's tools lets you add your proficiency bonus to any ability checks you make using the tools in your craft. For each type of artisan's tools require a separate proficiency. I would say none of those, actually.
No. I mean, does it say anything? Oh, it doesn't really...
No, it's just a list. You just have artisan's tools generally.
Oh, these aren't the...
No, they're specific other things.
So it doesn't really tell me what each thing does.
No,
or allows
it just gives you a weight and a cost and what they are.
But it doesn't tell me what I can do with them?
I think that's just open. Well, if you take cobbler's tools, you can make shoes with them. That's essentially... If you take woodcarver's tools, you can carve wood with them.
Arrows are made of wood.
Yeah, but there's also the part where you do the flights and you also do the tip, which are not necessarily made of wood.
And it can be.
They can. There's no boyer's tools here.
This is why Hal hates playing games with me.
To be honest, I could easily see artisan's tools. As there is a smith's tools, I don't see why you couldn't have a boyer's tools, which would be enough tools to make bows and arrows. That would make sense.
But there isn't one.
Well, I'm the GM, and I say there should be.
So, okay, so I can put that on here?
I agree, that is a fair thing. You want to be an archer.
Yeah.
Boyer's a trade. I don't see why you can't have tools to be one, so yes, you can.
How do you spell that?
B-O-W-Y-E-R. Boyer. Let's say they weigh the same as... I don't know.
Do I need to be putting weights next to these things?
No, we'll figure it out later. Your strength's not big, but not...
Oh, should I put that under equipment or proficiency?
It's both, actually. Well, technically you get the equipment in a minute.
Okay.
But you're proficient with that. No. You're proficient with Boyer's tools. Equipment. A set of artisan's tools. One of your choice.
So...
Boyer's tool.
No, you mean the one... No, I want one that I chose I'm not proficient with.
I want alchemist's tools, but I'm proficient with something else. I'm going to sell those alchemist's tools because they're 50 gold. Buy a Boyer set at 8 and keep the difference.
Oh, wait, can I?
No, you can't.
Shit! Fuck!
Alright, a shovel.
Ooh.
Yes, all of your very own. An iron pot.
To piss in?
Probably. A set of common clothes. And a belt pouch. Containing 10 gold pieces, which go in these neat little gold PC boxes over here. Belt pouch. There we go.
That's all they wrote, bet pouch.
Bet pouch. It's where you put your
money. That's my bet money.
That's right. And gold pieces, that's not gold. It's copper, silver, electrum, and gold. Electrum has made a return, I noticed.
10?
10. Because you're only a folk.
These are printed off, so...
Yeah, they're photocopies.
It's kind of hard to read some of the
stuff. Yeah, they're actually photocopies of a print. So yes, they're a little bit deep.
Did you make a clone of a clone now?
I did, apparently. And genetically, it is inferior. You have a defining event. You can either choose to roll randomly or pick one.
What are my choices?
I stood up to a tyrant's agents.
Okay.
I saved people during a natural disaster. Mm-hmm. I stood alone against a terrible monster.
Okay.
I stole from a corrupt merchant to help the poor. I led a militia to fight off an invading army. I broke into a tyrant's castle and stole weapons to arm the people. I trained the peasantry to use farm implements as weapons against a tyrant's soldiers. A lord rescinded an unpopular decree after I led a symbolic act of protest. A celestial fae or similar creature gave me a blessing or revealed my secret origin.
Wait. Does that mean the Lady of the Lake gave me a sword?
I think so. Recruited into a lord's army, I rose to leadership and was commended for my heroism.
Let me read through those so you don't have to read them out loud to these people again.
These people. Those five people listening.
There might be six. You don't know.
I guess I have to listen to it at least once.
Say people don't have to sit up alone against the... Man, I wish it was like I saw my parents killed in a dark alley.
That's more of a criminal than going to Batman.
Yes, I want to be Batman. I want to be Batman.
Doesn't really make you a folk hero, does it?
Doesn't it, though?
Yes.
Fine, my uncle was shot after I failed to stop a robber.
You're not Spider-Man, but...
You know...
You know Robin Hood. I came back from the Crusades and mystically teleported... to Hadrian's Wall, and then back to my lands in Nottingham. That's the best part of Robin Hood. He's walking along Hadrian's Wall, and he says the words, "These are the boundaries of my father's lands."
All right.
Which makes him about 150 miles, 200 miles too far north.
Maybe his father has huge tracts of land.
Yes, very good.
can't have a nerd show without a Monty Python reference.
That's right. It's ubiquitous. So, pick it. What made you a folk hero? Come on, Woody Elf. Let's see what you've got.
It's so difficult.
It's not that hard. It's the only thing you're going to be talking about in character. I remember when... This is nothing like the time I stood up to that tyrant.
I think it's going to be I stood alone against a terrible monster.
Sounds good. Sounds like an outdoorsy thing to do. You can pad that out later.
So do I put that anywhere? Or
there's a whole back of the sheet for that kind of crap. So I'm guessing it goes in...
Character background? Yeah, I stood alone against...
Just write it in there. You stood alone against a terrible monster. And you have the new feature, Rustic Hospitality.
Does that even do anything?
What? No, it just gives you a background. It's your defining event.
I have to choose a defining event?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I think it's ridiculous to make me choose from a list of defining events.
No, I like it. It's good. It gives you background to your character, which is something I think recent D&D has been missing a great deal of. It's very much about the crunch and not about the backstory. So now you have a backstory that you can build automatically into your character.
I mean, I guess it's kind of nice that they're forcing someone to create a character.
Yes, that's the point. But you're thinking about it.
At the same time, mm-hmm. I liked it better when it was like, you need to, when your DM would kind of like crack the whip on you.
Make a backstory.
Yeah,
that's hard though for some people. This gives you some hooks to start with. Yeah. If you're just kind of rolling it up on the fly, it gives you a hook to start with that you can play with.
I stood up against a rodent of unusual size.
That's right, when I was tasked with cleaning out the basement, as is traditional. Okay, let's say the starter set adventure, the Fandelbert Mines, actually has goblins in it as its first monster. As is traditional. Okay, so now you're going to do your personality trait, your ideas, your bonds, and your flaws.
Okay.
Which is another bunch of lists that I'm going to read to you, and you're going to pick one. Personality trait, as a folk hero, are you ready? I judge people by their actions, not their words. Okay. If someone is in trouble, I'm always ready to lend help. When I set my mind to something, I follow through no matter what gets in my way. I have a strong sense of fair play, always try to find the most equitable solution to arguments.
Clearly, you've never
which
talked
is
to me.
Holding a shattered bottle against the neck of the vizier. I'm confident in my own abilities and do what I can to instill confidence in others.
That one actually doesn't. I like that can quickly become I'm an arrogant jackass.
I've got a better one. Thinking is for other people, I prefer action. I misuse long words in an attempt to sound smarter.
I misuse
long words in an attempt to sound... I think it's fantastic as a character, as a personality thing. I think that's great. Especially with, oh, your int isn't your dump stat. You're actually quite smart. I get bored easily when I'm going to get... when am I going to get on with my destiny? That's your choices.
I feel like the Destiny one could be very good for, like...
I'm tired
of this shit. That's, wake up! I only have to sleep for 4 hours.
Your choice.
I mean, I'm
thinking
sorry.
Is for other people. I prefer action.
That is a good one.
It is a good one.
I like when I set my mind to something, I follow through no matter what gets in the way.
I know.
I don't care how many small babies I must attach against the rocks.
Yeah. The rogue I had is, I don't pay attention to the risks in a situation, never tell me the odds.
you fucking chose Han Solo. You made Han Solo.
Basically, right. And then, yeah, then we get onto ideas, and then we get onto bonds, and then flaws. And flaws is what gives you inspiration.
I think I
like
the...
Special swanky points.
So, I'm confident in my abilities.
I am confident in my own abilities, and do what I can to instill confidence in others. That's kind of a good folk hero-y thing. I need you to pick an alignment.
That's
well,
totally going to be me being a jackass and being a fucking arrogant prick.
You're going to be instilling confidence in others. I think you are. You're instilling. So next is your ideal. And this tends to kind of link to your alignment, so you may want to pick an alignment. It doesn't have to, but maybe this will lead you to an alignment.
Let's hear what...
Okay, ideal. Respect. People deserve to be treated with dignity and respect.
Clearly they don't.
Fairness. No one should get preferential treatment before the law, and no one is above the law. I am the law!
I know, I'm fucking Judge Dredd all of a sudden.
Yeah. Freedom. Tyrants must not be allowed to oppress the people. Might. If I become strong, I can take what I want... What I deserve.
Holy shit, that's creepy.
That's the evil alignment.
Yeah.
Sincerity. There's no good in pretending to be something I'm not. Destiny. Nothing and no one can steer me away from my higher calling.
That's all... That could very easily be, like, good or evil.
That's why it says any next to it.
Yeah.
So, that's the choices for ideal.
What's the freedom one calling for?
Tyrant. It's chaotic. Tyrants must not be allowed to oppress the people.
I'm going
to
go with freedom. I like that one.
Okay, so your alignment probably is chaotic something.
Yeah. Okay. So ideals are freedom.
Yes. Tyrants must not be allowed to oppress the people.
Do I just write down freedom or do I need to write out...
Yeah, write it all. Right. Tyrants, because the other rogue I drew up is chains are meant to be broken, as are those who would forge them.
I'm just going to write tyrants be dicks, yo.
Tyrants be dicks, yo. I like that. Okay, next is your bond. So, I have a family, but I have no idea where they are. One day, I hope to see them again.
I try not to use slurs against people, but there's a word that starts with a G and ends with A that I really want to use right now.
Don't use that. I worked the land, I love the land, and I will protect the land.
That's not too bad, like...
A proud noble once gave me a horrible beating, and I will take my revenge on any bully I encounter. My tools are symbols of my past life, and I carry them so that I will never forget my roots. That's where you've got that iron pot. I protect those who cannot protect themselves. I wish my childhood sweetheart had come to me to pursue my come with me to pursue my destiny.
Pussy.
Your choice.
So, what is it? And does it say bombed. Anything next
nope.
to him? Or
nope, you just get to pick one. The other rogue said, "Someone I loved died because of a mistake I made. That will never happen again."
I think as a ranger, mm-hmm. the worked the land, loved the land.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Kind of adventurer, outdoorsy type.
Yeah, that's a good one. You look after the common people. Okay, the next thing is your flaw. And your flaw is your key to getting a thing called inspiration, which lets you spend points of that or donate it or give it to other people who do cool things so that they can spend points of that. It's like hero points. The tyrant who rules my land will stop at nothing to see me killed.
Clearly there's not a tyrant that rules my land because I would have killed him already.
I'm confident of the significance of my destiny and blind to my shortcomings and the risk of failure.
That actually goes well with my personality trait.
So far. The people who knew me when I was young know my shameful secret, so I can never go home again. I have a weakness for the vices of the city, especially hard drink.
See, had I picked that brewer's kid, that would have been my go-to.
Secretly, I believe that things would be better if I were a tyrant lordling over the land. I have trouble trusting my allies.
Are those my choices?
Uh-huh.
What was the hubris one?
Hubris. You mean, I'm convinced of the significance of my destiny and blind to my shortcomings and the risk of failure.
I think that will go well with my arrogance.
Complete down.
So...
I'm convinced of the significance of my destiny.
The only thing I don't like about that is, like, the... of my destiny.
Well, the idea is, as a folk hero, you're destined for good things. So basically the idea is you stood up against a terrible monster and everybody tells you you're amazing and you kind of buy into that a little bit. That's why you're a folk hero. They think you have a big destiny.
I wish it was more like, I'm convinced of my own greatness.
Well, it's similar.
I just don't like the word destiny.
You can, well, that's what you can be. You can be great if you wish. I don't care how you interpret. Good?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's pretty much it.
So my alignment is probably going to be...
chaotic something. Probably good, because you do seem to be standing up for the people.
You don't know how much I'm robbing of other people, though.
Well, that's the choice. It could be chaotic neutral.
I do like the neutrality of neutralness.
I do like being
neutral. It allows me to be a lot more morally ambiguous.
Like being neutral.
I think I'm going to go with chaotic neutral.
We need dice for your height. Because you're an elf, you need D10s. I need to open my dice bag, which is stuck. There we go. Dice bag, you can have D10s. D10s. I'm sure there's a good, lovely D10. You can roll this pink D10. Lindsay stole all my nice dice. Lindsay has a lovely, and that pink D10.
So I need to roll two?
Yeah, you need two D10, and it needs to be added to 4'6" as inches. 7. So that makes you 5'1".
Seriously?
Seriously.
Oh. 5'1" adventuring elf.
You're 5'1", dude. That's what it says. 5'1".
Oh my god.
Right down. Height. It's on the back, I think.
You fucking rat bastard.
You're 5'1", and that makes your... You need to roll a d4 to get the base modifier for your weight.
I'm a midget elf.
all elves are kind of small. Your base is 4'6" and you roll 2d10. Yeah, I guess you're a little bit under average.
Yeah.
Roll that. Yep, 4. Multiply that by 7.
4 times 7 is, oh shit, 28.
Very good. Add that to 100 pounds.
128?
Yep.
I guess that's not a bad weight.
That's not a bad weight.
5'1".
It's not bad. Now you need, like, an age and sex and business, but we can figure that out later. So you need to do the numbers on the front of your sheet. That's basically all the grunt work we've done. So down here are your saves. Their strength, the dex, the con, the int, the whiz, and the charisma are all saves. So basically this is -1. It's just the modifier. Dexterity, because you are proficient in that save, is +2 because that's your proficiency bonus. So it's technically +6. It's 4 + 2 = +6.
6. Constitution would be +2.
Correct.
Intelligence is +3.
Mm-hmm.
Wisdom is +1,
yep.
And charisma is +1.
It's all good. And then skills work exactly the same. So you add your proficiency here, except for your expertise doubles your proficiency for athletics and acrobatics.
All right. So
you're going to have dex-based acrobatics is +4 from dexterity, +2 from proficiency, +2 from expertise gives you a +8 in acrobatics. So you're pretty acrobatic as a level 1 character.
And then athletics is going to be, it's going to be, it'll be... So,
+2.
+2, -1.
Yeah, +2 again.
So, that'd be 3?
Yeah, +3. Which is better than nothing.
And then for everything else,
it's a straight +2 if you're proficient, or just the stat if you're not. But Wiz is +1, so that's +3.
So oh,
it's wisdom based.
Oh, it's proficiency plus...
Plus your stat, yes.
Right.
And that's what you roll, basically, when you're rolling your skills.
So that was my animal?
Yeah, animal handling. You get +2 for proficiency, and then you get...
Wait, didn't we do something else with the animal handling, too? Oh, no, I got that for...
You got that for being a folk hero.
That's right, so +3.
Yep.
So our...
Is int.
So that's going to be...
Just a straight +1.
+1?
Yep. Okay, I don't have anything negatives unless it's strength-based, you're good.
Charisma is +1.
Yep.
History is...
Int-based.
+1. Insight
Wiz-based.
Is...
+1.
+1.
Yay.
Intimidation is +3.
Uh-huh. You got it.
Investigation is +1. Medicine, +1.
Now what I noticed is the experience is really, really short in this. The advance, I think you only need like 335,000 XP to be like level 20, which I thought was kind of interesting.
The only thing that is strength-based is athletics.
Yeah. There's nothing con-based either.
So that's not bad that, like, I don't have any... Since I chose that as a proficiency thing...
You don't have it as a weakness.
I don't have anything in the negative.
That's a good thing.
Suck it, bitches.
The other character has no negative stats. There's some zeros, but no negatives.
I think my religion should be like -800.
So you're chaotic neutral in the end. Is that what you are?
I think so, yeah, sure.
Let's read what it says about chaotic neutral while you're filling in your statistics. Chaotic neutral. Creatures follow their whims, holding their personal freedom above all else. Many barbarians and rogues and some bards are chaotic neutral. The other character is chaotic good, which is they act as their conscience directs with little regard for what others expect. Copper dragons, many elves, and unicorns are chaotic good.
Unicorns! Oh, Tote's gonna get me a unicorn, you know.
Tote's gonna get
I got
me
animal
unicorn.
Handling.
Okay, inspiration, which is... Oh, we need to figure out your armor class and stuff. But inspiration here is a rule that I can use to reward you for playing your character in a way that's true to your personality traits, ideal, bond, and flaw. So basically, if you play your character well, I can give you a point of inspiration. So by using inspiration, you can draw on your personality trait of compassion for the downtrodden to give an edge in negotiating with the beggar prince. Or inspiration can let you call on your bond to the defense of the home village, blah, blah, blah. So basically, I choose to give you inspiration for a variety of reasons. Typically, I award it when you play your personality traits, giving to your backgrounds represented by your flaw or bonds, or otherwise portray your character in a compelling way. And I tell you how you can earn... Well, apparently I will tell you how to earn it. Just play a goddamn character.
So, as long as I stay, like, a kind of arrogant douche who fucking helps people out that are downtrodden...
Right. Yeah.
You're good. Sweet. So,
yeah. You either have inspiration or you don't. You can't stockpile multiple inspirations for use later. So if you have inspiration, so basically it's a check or not a check, you can expend it when you make an attack roll, saving throw, or ability check. Spending your inspiration gives you advantage on that roll. Now, advantage means that when you roll the d20 and add your skill, you actually roll 2d20 and take the highest. And the disadvantage is you roll 2d20 and take the lowest. Which is kind of cool. I kind of like that. I'd be interested to see how that plays out.
So if you use your inspiration, you...
You have advantage automatically.
But then you like take away the check...
And yeah, it's gone. And then you have to get it back by gaming again.
But no way of knowing when the DM...
And we'll give you it back. No way at all. Additionally, if you have inspiration, you can reward another player for good role-playing, clever thinking, or simply doing something exciting. When another player character does something that really contributes to the story in a fun and interesting way, you can give up your inspiration to give it to that character. I think that's kind of cool, too. I mean, it allows for camaraderie within the group, kind of like that.
And then if there's a character that's all about helping other people,
yeah.
The DM can be like, oh, give them inspiration. I'm going to reward you with inspiration.
That's exactly never going to happen.
We all just have an inspiration circle jerk.
That's right. There's jerking of the inspiration. So, we need to figure out your initiative, which is basically a dexterity check. So, you're going to get plus 6 initiative. Is that correct?
I don't know.
It may just be plus 4. I don't know whether you get your proficiency on initiative or not. It may just be your dex. I'll check that out. Your armor class for leather armor, we need to look up. It'd be here somewhere. Okay, your armor class for leather armor is 11 plus your dex modifier.
So 6? Oh no, that's my saving test.
That's 4. Yeah.
So,
It's 15.
15, right?
Yep, that's it.
Sorry.
Welcome back to the land of low armor class.
God.
It's like playing AD&D again, and I kind of like that. Kind of like that.
Are all the numbers low, or like
almost every number is low?
Just stupid fuck.
Well, like this: when you make your character, you can roll once on the trinkets table. Do you like to roll on the trinkets table?
What does that do?
Gives you some useless shit to weigh you down. Roll.
Yes.
Which one is tens? Pink or red?
Aren't they? Are they not both?
They are. Just tell me which one is tens, which one is units.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you asked me.
Sorry, I play Rollmaster too much. Which one is tens?
Alright, so let's say the red is tens.
Roll it. So that's a 95.
Yeah.
You have a petrified mouse. Congratulations.
What do I do with a fucking petrified mouse?
I have no idea, but you have a petrified mouse.
Is it... How's it pet like?
I don't know.
Wait, like turn to mineral or just really fucking scared?
I guess that's your choice to interpret that one. Is it just really scared? I'm constantly in a state of fear.
I have a scared mouse, which goes with my animal handling. I have a pet mouse to do my bidding.
But it's scared.
Well, you know, it's seen some shit, yo.
Geek-a-saurus.